In this video, I want to take a quick moment and explain the differences between the FileMaker products so you can understand which products you should be buying for your organization. Buying the right mix of FileMaker products for your team or organization is a critical first step towards successful deployment of a FileMaker solution. We will also discuss how each of these product capabilities and their associated licensing or pricing affects how you will purchase and deploy them within your organization. First off, you have FileMaker Pro and FileMaker Pro Advanced on Mac and Windows. FileMaker Pro is the absolute cornerstone of the FileMaker product line. This allows you complete client access or user access to your databases. It also is the development environment where you're going to develop your solution. Now, the difference between FileMaker Pro and FileMaker Pro Advanced is that Advanced has a handful of developer-specific features. For example, you can import themes, you can manage custom functions, you can also access the script debugger, which is super useful if you're writing scripts, and also the data viewer. There's a handful of other items in there, but FileMaker Pro Advanced is super useful if you're doing a lot of FileMaker development. Then there's FileMaker Server. FileMaker Server is what's going to host your FileMaker database on your local area network and also on the internet. If your FileMaker Server has a static IP address and also your network router allows internet access to your FileMaker Server, that server can host databases out on the internet to remote users. Those remote users can be using FileMaker Pro or FileMaker Pro Advanced. Now, there's another client those users can be using, and that's FileMaker Go. FileMaker Go is a software that's specific for the iPhone and iPad. This software is not available for the Android platform. Now, FileMaker Go is completely free to download off Apple's App Store, and you can freely use local databases that are loaded locally into the flash memory of your mobile device. However, if you want to connect to a FileMaker server, you're going to need to make sure that that FileMaker server has a concurrent connection license installed on that server. And this requires a bit of explanation. Starting with FileMaker 13, in order for FileMaker Go users to access a FileMaker server, that server has to have a concurrent connection license installed on it. And the reason for this is that FileMaker Go is free, and so FileMaker had to monetize in some way the product. And the way they do this is for users who want remote internet access to their databases. The cost is very reasonable. By purchasing a concurrent license and inputting that license key on your FileMaker server, FileMaker Go users can access databases on your FileMaker server just like FileMaker Pro users do. Now, FileMaker Pro users don't need to have that concurrent license installed on FileMaker server. FileMaker Pro users have already paid for the client software. Therefore, they get access to FileMaker server without any additional fees. So far we've discussed FileMaker Pro and Pro Advanced on Mac and Windows, FileMaker Go on iOS for iPhone and iPad, and there's a third client that's available, which is brand new to the platform, called FileMaker Web Direct. WebDirect is a browser-based client that was first introduced with the FileMaker 13 platform. Now, you access WebDirect by using a modern browser like Internet Explorer, Google Chrome, or Apple Safari. Most functions and capabilities that are part of the FileMaker platform work on WebDirect. But WebDirect is not as powerful nor as quick as FileMaker Pro is. For this reason, WebDirect is not a replacement for FileMaker Pro. In fact, just because it's a browser doesn't mean that WebDirect is free. If you want to use a browser to access WebDirect, a free client, you're going to need to make sure that that FileMaker server has a concurrent connection license installed on it, just like it did for FileMaker Go. In fact, the concurrent connection license that you install works simultaneously for FileMaker Go clients and WebDirect clients. FileMaker Go clients are free, and the WebDirect clients, because it's a browser, are free as well. But to access FileMaker Server, both of these clients must have a concurrent connection license installed on the server they intend to access. So in summary, if you've purchased your FileMaker client, like FileMaker Pro or Pro Advanced, you do not have to pay any additional fees to connect to FileMaker Server. However, if your client was free, like a web browser for WebDirect, or you download FileMaker Go for free from Apple's App Store, you will need to make sure a connection license has been purchased and installed on the FileMaker Server that you're going to be working with. So now that we understand that we have three separate FileMaker clients that we can use to access a database, how do we choose the right one for our organization? Well, all the development must be done in FileMaker Pro. You can choose to do the development in FileMaker Pro or Pro Advanced, depending upon the complexity of the development you need to do. There is no development at all in FileMaker Go or in WebDirect. FileMaker Go and WebDirect are only for accessing and using the database. FileMaker Pro is by far the fastest and richest and highest speed client to access the database. So for maximum performance and greatest flexibility, FileMaker Pro is your best option. Your best mobile option is going to be FileMaker Go on your iPhone and iPad. If you don't have a lot of data to access, then the iPhone might be a good option, or maybe an iPad mini. But if you have a screen with lots of information on it, you're going to want to think about using a full-size iPad with a larger screen real estate for your mobile device. For limited deployments within your own organization, or with limited deployments to trusted third parties, WebDirect may be a good answer for you if those users don't need heavy-duty access to the database. Keep in mind, because we're using a browser and not a dedicated client like FileMaker Pro, WebDirect doesn't have all the capabilities and all the performance and speed that's contained within FileMaker Pro. Now, of course, everyone has a web browser on their machine, so more than likely, almost everyone can run WebDirect. So that gives you a great deal of flexibility. And that's the benefits of WebDirect. You don't have to install anything on a user's machine to give them basic access to FileMaker. But if those users need persistent, in-depth access to FileMaker, they may not necessarily be well served by WebDirect. And you should consider installing FileMaker Pro on those users' machines. And lastly, if you need public access to your database, you need to strongly look at hiring a developer or learning yourself how to build PHP-based pages that are published to the internet by a web server, such as Windows IIS, or by the Macintosh via Apache for high-speed public access to a web browser. And there are a large number of FileMaker developers available across North America and the world, for that matter, that are available to help if you need assistance with this task. So consider the right client for the right job. As a developer or a decision maker in your organization, you need to choose the right mix of clients to ensure success for the deployment of your database. Most likely, you're going to see a mix of clients. In a lot of situations, we're seeing a FileMaker server. Anywhere from 60 to 70% of the users will be using FileMaker Pro. Typically, another 25% of the users on an iPad or iPhone, with a handful of users who have very limited needs using WebDirect. Once again, WebDirect is still a new technology, and it doesn't have all the capabilities or performance that you have with FileMaker Pro. So it's a good idea to limit your WebDirect users to just those people who need limited offsite access in a very minimal sort of way. Now, that's not always the case, but we never see all the users just using one type of client. These days, it's always a mix, using the right tool for the right job.